Hi friends, this is Fani Bhushan Nagula. Today we are going to learn TestNG. So TestNG is a test automation framework. So let me write some notes here. TestNG is a test automation framework. It was created by Cedric Yost. So what is mean by TestNG? So NG stands for next generation. So it was developed based on JUnit, which uses annotations. So TestNG contains more annotations and it is very easy to understand and implement. So let's understand some of the advantages of TestNG framework. Advantages. The first advantage here is Selenium WebDriver doesn't have test reporting mechanism. So it doesn't have a test reporting mechanism. It cannot generate test reports. So whatever in our LA session, whatever the results we have seen it in the console mode. Now we do not have a facility to generate the reports in HTML format or more user-friendly format. So we need to depend on a framework which helps us to provide the reports in HTML format and more easily readable format. So TestNG is one of the great framework, and it also helps us to group the test cases, to group multiple test cases. For example, if you have hundreds of test cases or thousands of test cases and you want to execute some of the test cases, like for example you want to create a test group for sanity, you want to create a test group for functional, you want to create a test group for integration, one group for regression purpose. So you want to create multiple groups and you want to execute the groups based on your requirement. So for example, now let me write down whatever we are discussing. TestNG generates reports which HTML reports, let me put it in a HTML reports. HTML reports, so which contains number of test cases, passed, failed, skipped. And second point, what we have discussed is you can group multiple test cases and execute it. And we can prioritize test cases. Why? Because in some cases you want to change the order of test cases and execute the priority one. And also you can select the test cases based on the priority you want to select the priority one test case to be executed. And the fourth point is TestNG suites can be easily integrated with tools like Maven or Jenkins. Easily integrate with tools like Maven, Jenkins, etc. And the fifth point here is using TestNG we can do parallel testing. So parallel testing is possible through parallel testing is possible through TestNG framework. So we will in our sessions about TestNG we will understand how each one of these advantages can be used in our projects. So let's first install the TestNG. Before installing it, let's go to their official site, testng.org. testng.org. So you can click on download link here. So you can also read some information about TestNG test framework inspired from JUnit and NUnit, and it contains annotations. So there are a lot of information is available here. So let's click on the download first. If you scroll down a little bit, so here we have some installation information. So here what it says is Java 1.7 plus 7 and above version is required for running the TestNG for Eclipse plugin. And at the same time, Eclipse 4.2 and above is required. So now it is not supporting Eclipse 3.x. So now we need to install 4.2. I think because we are using Eclipse Photon, it is the latest version. Let's look at what is our, it is 4.8. So we are using the latest version. Now here, if you understand, install from the update side. Here, there are various methods available to install TestNG. So one of it is, it says that you can go to help and install new software option. From there you can install. Let's understand this one in the Eclipse. So here you can click on install new software, or you can go to Eclipse marketplace. Let's understand here. So what they are saying is, in the install new software, if you provide this link and just click on add, it will ask for the TestNG and click add. Now what it is doing, it is fetching all the children elements, all the from the boost.com Eclipse site. So if you go and type this in Google, so let's enter. It's taking you to the site from where you can download the TestNG plugin. So 6.14 is the latest one. So if you click on it, so you can composite artifacts.xml and composite content.xml. So it is taking you from where you can download the plugins. So you can download the plugin from here. But now we have a facility available to download and install from Eclipse. So now we got the result now. So you just select this TestNG, because I have already installed it. It's not giving me to click next time, but in your case, if you're freshly installing it, you will get this option. You can click on next, and it will accept the agreement. You can able to install it. And look at one more option and go to help. Click on Eclipse Marketplace. So from here, you can able to install various plugins. So yeah, let's load all the now it's almost all available. Yes. Let me search for TestNG and click search, or maybe just press enter in this search text box. So you can see here the TestNG for Eclipse. This plugin lets you run your TestNG tests from the Eclipse. You can run feeds, groups, or individual methods. errors are reported in a separate tab that lets you, so there are a lot of information available here also as a description for this plugin. Now click on install. So in your case, when you are installing it freshly, you will get install button, so like the other one. So click on install and you just click on next, and you'll just proceed with all the recommendations and accept the agreement, and then you will be able to install it. In my case, I have installed it. So once you have installed the TestNG, there are various methods to understand whether the installation is successful or not. So one is, go to Windows and Preferences. You should be able to view the TestNG here. You should be able to view the TestNG here. It means that my TestNG is successfully installed. Or under, if you right click on the project, again you will get TestNG option. So here you can create a TestNG class, or you can convert the TestNG classes into test suites. So it means that your TestNG is successfully installed. Or you can go to new. So in under new, you go to other. So you have a TestNG option under that. You have TestNG class. So these are the ways you can find whether the TestNG installation is successful or not. Let's create a sample TestNG class and understand that how it works. So let me create it from here. Click next. As I mentioned that TestNG is based on JUnit and NUnit, which uses annotations. Here also, TestNG provides more annotations. I'm going to use the basic test method. So let me write down the class name. Let me click on this package and go to new and select other. Now create your TestNG class, and let me say first TestNG example. So let me click on finish. So here, if you see, by default, it has added the @ test annotation here. So annotations are used @ and the annotation name here. But now here, even though it has downloaded, imported the packages, but still there is something error here. If you take your cursor to here, it is requesting for @TestNG library. So it is not able to locate the TestNG library. If you just go here and click @TestNG library, so it will be adding your TestNG library here. So now let me change the method name here. Now earlier in our earlier sessions, when we have used Java class, we used to select public static void main, and that using main method we used to execute all our test cases. But in TestNG, we do not need main method. So our annotations will help us to execute our test methods. And @test represents a test method. It's a test case method. So let me write my, or you can say first test case. And let me write this out. Yeah, within this This is my first TestNG test case. Okay. Now, when you right click here to run the TestNG, you can see it is TestNG test. But in other case, when you are executing Java class, run as you are getting Java application, run as Java application. But in TestNG, we are getting TestNG run as TestNG test. Okay. Now let's execute it now. So allow access. Yeah. It has executed the test case. Now if you see, earlier our test case execution results in this console also it was little different. Now if you look at this, it is showing the total number of test cases run is 1 and there are no failures. So if there are any failures, it will show the number, how many test cases are failed and how many test cases are skipped. So this is as part of the console, and you can see our test case has printed the statement or the message which we have written. This is my first TestNG test case. And there is another way to look at our result is in a tree structure is all test and failed and summary. So anyway, we do not have any fail and we have a summary for the default test case. But when you look at your all test, it is showing we have Selenium tutorials, our package dot first TestNG example. This is our test case. Your package dot your test case class. And your first test case is the method which you have used under first TestNG example class. Now, if you look at the write method, so the icon. It means that it's passed. If it is failed, it will show X mark or multiplication mark to mention that it is failed. Now, let's understand how it generates other reports like HTML report. Go to your project, right click and click on select refresh option now. So you see here we have this, we got a new folder called test output. We got a new folder called test output. Now if you open this test output, we have various files here. We have emailable report, we have index.html. Let's select index.html, right click on this index.html, open with web browser. So here this is our report. Otherwise you can also open this in the, now for example if you go to index.html, right click on the property, right click and select properties, you can take the complete path of this and you can go to your or maybe from here you just go to browser and enter. So here if you see we have one method and one method is passed. If you go click on result, so you can see the result, the first test case is passed. So there's the pass methods. So this is the way you can see how many passed, how many failed, or if anything is skipped, you can see skipped one also. So thanks for watching the session. In the next session, we will understand more annotations and also the methods available in TestNG to take advantage as part of our projects.